How can you install RetroFoam if your home has Hardie board? Let's talk about it. So we do get a lot of calls and messages from homeowners asking us, hey, I want RetroFoam in my house, but I have Hardie board on the outside. Can this be done? Super common question. Short answer, yes, absolutely it can be done. Now you may be asking yourself, what's Hardie board? Well, if you have to ask, it probably doesn't apply to you, but you may know Hardie board as cement board. So the install process can be similar to how aluminum siding is taken off, but it is a little different, obviously, being a totally different material. But essentially, what you're going to do is it should be caulked at the seams, and so it may not be, but if it is, you want to make sure you cut that, obviously, open that up, and you're going to want to lift the board above. You may have to lift the board below depending on how it's stacked and how close, and obviously when you're prying this off, be very, very careful. I know even me just saying prying it off is making some siders and homeowners very nervous. Unfortunately, it's really the only way to do it. Hardie board's pretty tough stuff. So, I mean, you can really work at it with a pry bar and a few tools. And it's got some give before it actually cracks or breaks. But of course, that's always the risk, is if you do pry on it too much or into one area before you have even pressure throughout the rest of the board, you do run the risk of cracking that board. So that's always the risk of removing Hardie board or doing an install with Hardie board, is cracking or breaking that board. You do always want to be very, very careful, but as installers will know, it can take much more punishment than you would think. One of the biggest benefits to Hardie board is its durability, especially if a region has hailstorms. They like Hardie board siding because it can be more protective on the house. Do not just go crazy with it though. You don't want to break a homeowner's very beautiful siding, because that's one of the big pros to having Hardie board, is it's decorative, it's beautiful, and the texturing of it is nice. Once you get that off, then your install is as normal as any other type of install. You're going to drill a hole to access your cavity. You're going to, of course, you know, fill it up with foam, plug holes, clean everything up. When you replace that board, the refastening of it, you will get 100 different answers. The most common ways to put it back on is using a nail gun, and it's best to use a nail gun that has an angle on the end of the gun so that you can up angle the nails, and really because you want to get the nails less visible, right? You don't want a nail head exposed on the outside of your Hardie board, because that's going to take away from the beautiful aesthetics. Now, of course, this was a very quick, broad overview of how to take it off and on. Of course, in person, it's a little more complicated than that, and some of those steps can take some time. Prying it off, you got to be ginger. You got to take your time and be a little slow with it. And of course, you'll want at least two people to make sure, you know, you can keep it level and it's not drooping on one side, because that can increase the risk of cracking and breaking that board. And yes, the siders and contractors of the world will tell me in the comments that their way is right and the next comments guy's way is right. There's many different ways to do it. These are just the broad strokes. And the point is to show you, the homeowner, even if you have Hardie board, it can safely be removed and reinstalled so that you can have a nicely insulated home and still have that beautiful siding on the outside. Now, if you do have a home with Hardie board and you're ready to take back the comfort and control of your home today, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page, where you can meet your local RetroFoam dealer. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.